QR, the composition we will see next time. I want instead to start to talk about the so-called pseudo-immersement. So we all know that if A is n by n matrix and the determinant of A is different from zero, if and only if there exists A to the minus 1 such that A to the minus 1 A is equal to A times A to the minus 1 is equal to the identity matrix. We want to generalize. The problem is that this inverse matrix does not exist every time. If the determinant is different from zero, this exists. If it is equal to zero, it does not exist. We want to generalize this inverse. More precisely, we want to show this theorem. Let A C M times N. So the pseudo inverse, it exists for any matrix, so even for rectangular matrix, so even if M is different from N, then there exists a unique matrix A plus, I call it the textbook or A plus, such that, so in order to be unique, we require some conditions. And there are four conditions. So the first condition, A, A plus, A has to be equal to A. Second condition, A plus, A, A plus, has to be equal to A plus. Third condition, A, A plus is equal to A, A plus conjugated and transposed at Hermitian numbers. And fourth condition, A plus A is equal to A plus. Number of rows of A, and the consistency among these conditions.
These are not
obviously trivially false. Can be true, maybe. We want to show that actually they are true. And if and only if we choose A plus in a certain way. First of all, if A is square matrix and it is invertible, we still don't know if these conditions are sufficient to say that A plus is unique, but one matrix that can be put on in the place of A plus, we know, which is if A is like before, square, if it is not rectangle, it's just square with the element different from zero, what I can put in the place of A plus?
The inverse,
because A times A to the minus 1 is the identity matrix times A is A. Here we have A minus 1, A minus 1 is A minus 1. This is identity, and it, of course it is outer medium, and this is identity, the same identity in this outer medium. It is straight. So, if we can prove that this matrix exists and it is unique, then we can prove that this matrix generalizes in some sense the inverse. Okay? Because of course when A is invertible it should be the inverse matrix. So then okay. We sketch part of the proof because we will not be half an hour is not enough. But part of the proof. First of all, this is 5 minutes. We prove that this matrix, if it is it exists, it is unique. Okay? So, proof and uniqueness. Let B and C two matrices satisfying from 1 to 4 with respect. What do we want to prove? We want to prove that B is equal to C. So we have. Let us start with B. It is equal to B A. Big this is equal to CA BA H B, and this is equal to CA BA B, and this is equal to CA B. It's just a trick. So we started from B and we ended up with CAB. Okay? Now, by symmetry, we can start from C and perform on the right the analogous operations and to end with CAB. How? C it is equal to CAC. So this is equal to C CH so AC H. So this is equal to C CH AH. But this is equal. Start from this. We arrive to this. I want now to start from C and arrive that in the end I will get CAB.
To prove that B is BAC.
That B is equal to C.
But you can prove it now.
How?
Because BAB, the first one, BAB after
no, 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 no. That if you multiply two matrices by. So. Take two matrices, multiply by something, get zero. Can you say that B is equal to C? To C? No. It's not trivial. You cannot just. Cannot. Be careful. Even if this is square, how do you know that this is invertible? Let us say that you know this is square because we have to look for but how do you know that this is invertible? If this is the zero matrix, then BAB is zero, CAB is zero, but you cannot. Okay? No, no, it's not difficult because look, if we go CA on the left, we got on the left A and C. By symmetry, we can get on the right A and B. Performing exactly the same, but reflected to the right. So, you see, CAC, then ACH, because this is outer medial matrix. Then I do like this. Then I CCH I don't touch, like BBH I didn't touch. Then I can write that A is equal to ABA at this, and then I have to apply Hermitian operator, then I can write CCH AH BH AH. But this is ACH and this is ABH. But then, this is C, A, since when I have AC or AB, I can just drop this H, CH, AC, AB. But CAC is C, and then I have CAB. in the case of immutable matrices, we just prove the existence because the inverse it has this code. So the inverse is the pseudo inverse if there is the inverse. It is the inverse.
Also the pseudo.
Here we have 5, columns 4, 0, 5 times this column 10, 4, and so is 14 and 4. Because 1 plus 10 plus 3 is 14, 1 plus 5 is 5. No, this one, this time it was correct. It was 10, 5, not 10, 4. 10, 5 plus 4, 0 is 14, 5. Then, this minus this, 1 minus 2 plus 4, 4 is 5, 2. So, you can see, these columns are linear combination of these columns. This coefficient, this coefficient, the rows are linear combinations of these rows with this definition and this definition. So this straightforward from this it is straightforward to imply that the rank of A times B cannot be greater than the rank of A and the rank of B. Why? Because the rows of these matrix are cannot span a linear subspace more than the rows of A of B, and columns cannot span at a bigger subspace than the rows of the columns of A. So, if this M is less than N, when you multiply like this, you have n times n matrix, and if it is identity, it has rank m. And this rank cannot be bigger than m, and m is strictly less than n. On the contrary, this can be. This can be. Because nothing. I will give one example. This is, okay, let's take a 2x3 and so I have 5 minus 4, so 3, 1, 0, 2, minus 1, 1. Okay, let us multiply. 3 plus 2 is 5. So 3 plus 1 is 4. Minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2. 4 plus 2. 1, 0, you multiply, it does not seem trivial that this has zero determinant, but it's zero determinant. If we develop the determinant along the last row, 1, A plus 4 is 12, 2, 10 minus 16 is minus 6, minus 12, 12 minus 12 is 0. Actually, you can see that the last A3 is equal to A2 minus to A1 minus to A2. Divided by A1. twice 8 minus 5 divided by 3 is 1. 4 minus 4 divided by 3 is 0. 4 plus 2 divided by 3 is 2. So you can see it's not trivial. But okay, it is trivial, but because we know this rank is not bigger than 2, this rank is not bigger than 2, this rank is not bigger than 2. So if rank is not bigger than 2, the determinant is 0. Okay. On the opposite side, we can get the, let us say that, for example, we have 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Then we have 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. What do you get? 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, I can do some better example now. It takes some computation. Okay. Here I can put even 5, for example. I can put then I can put something in such way that will not be 0, 0 here. I can put some more elaborated example, but this just to say that it is possible. Okay? So let us say, for example, 5 minus 3, 0, 0. What is called this? This is called a left inverse. You know, you have A, you have some B, and this is the identity. Of course, the left inverse, it is possible when, if M is equal to 1, left inverse is equal to the right inverse, and it exists only if A is invertible. But if M is less than N, a left inverse, when it is possible, when this A is so-called a full rank matrix. So if this has rank 2, then you will have a left inverse. But if A has rank 1, of course the product has rank not bigger than 1, and so can never be. Why it is called full rank? Because you have, let us take, for example, a matrix 7 by 4. Full rank because the rank is 4, maximum is 4, more than 4 is not possible. In this case, it's called full rank. Okay? In this case, a left inverse is possible. And it exists. Why it is possible? Because, for example, let us put 5, 3, 0, 1. What I can do? 0, 0, 0, 1. Why it's possible? You can isolate the rows that give the minor that has the determinant. So if in this case you have m times n, m is bigger than n, and you know that rank of A is equal to n, this implies if and only if exists AHN such that the matrix AH1, AHN, the determinant is different from 0. in order to have rank n, n of the rows should be linearly independent. So you will have, and then in order to get a left inverse, what we have to do? Let us take this matrix and call this matrix, let us call it A prime. We put in the place of columns corresponded to A prime to the minus one. And in the other columns, we have something here, but in the other place we put zero. In order that when you multiply, you will get left inverse is not unique, because of course you can have several combinations of rows. Of course, if n is smaller than n, in the case that we want to examine to speak about before, then in that case we can have not a left inverse, we can have a right inverse. When we have this right inverse, if and only if matrix is full rank, but in this case full rank, it means that as the rank equal to the number of rows, okay, if m is smaller than n, okay, in that case we can have the right inverse. Okay. Okay. I will stop here, because next time we will see how this will help to construct the pseudo-inverse matrix. Just okay, in order to fill these 4 minutes, in your opinion, for example, let us say take the null matrix, zero matrix. I take M times N matrix with all zeros, which is the pseudo inverse. Is bigger. It is trivial. The null matrix, the transpose. Remember, you have to multiply the matrices. If you have null matrix 2 times 3, the pseudo inverse is the null matrix 3 by 2. Then you can verify, you can perform all products, and all products give 0, and 0 in the right space, and so you will get that. Even the zero matrix as the pseudo inverse. Every matrix as the pseudo inverse. And the pseudo inverse is unique. Next time we will construct the pseudo inverse for every matrix using this, what I told now. Then what we have to do? We have to see what this pseudo inverse actually does, and this will be very interesting. Okay. Because if I have a linear system AX equal to B, this system can have more than one solution. One solution, and this is more complicated to explain, but actually I will tell it now, but I will repeat many times next time, maybe after. It is like this. First, you have to project B on the space spanned by the column of A. If you remember, the system by Roche Capelli is can be solved if and only if B belongs to the span of the columns of A. First, you project B there. Then you take all solutions of AX equal to the projection of B, and then among all these solutions can be infinite, you will take the solutions, the solution that will have the minimal length. And this, to do all this stuff, it corresponds to apply A plus to B. Okay? And this we will do. But first we will build, we'll construct the pseudo-inverse matrix for any matrix A. And then we will prove that the action of A plus, when we have any system, even not solvable, it corresponds to what I just told. Okay? This we will do next time.
Okay. Tuesday.
Next time, Thursday. Next Thursday, just same.